Starting up, G7 countries during its meeting on 19th May had called for swift and comprehensive regulation of cryptocurrencies according to a draft communique.
In the light of the recent turmoil in the crypto asset market, the G7 urges the FSB to advance the swift development and implementation of consistent and comprehensive regulation. Finance ministers and central bankers, part of the group of seven industrialized nations, said in the document. The call for the regulation of crypto asset comes amidst the recent market turmoil following the unprecedented collapse of cryptocurrency Terra, an algorithmic stablecoin Terra USD. The G7 supports work by the FSB to monitor and address financial stability risks arising from all forms of crypto asset and welcomes increasing global cooperation to address regulatory issues associated with the use of crypto assets, including in cross-border payments. The published communique, which summarized the key decision, reads, the communique also notes that FSB would work in close coordination with international standard settlers on crypto regulation with a view of holding crypto assets, including stablecoins, to the same standards as the rest of the financial system. The communique concluded by noting that G7 remains highly committed to the high regulatory standards for global stablecoins, following the principle of the same risk, same activity and same regulation. Due to the recent market turmoil, many countries are now independently calling for urgent regulations of crypto assets. In the United States, Treasury Secretary Janet Yellen told Congress earlier this month that it is important and urgent to regulate stablecoins. The UK government has also recently reaffirmed the commitment to regulate stablecoins this week.
The G7 leader met in Coinswinter near Bonn. From May 18 to 20, the group of seven leading economies also agreed during its recent meeting to provide $19.8 billion in economic aid to Ukraine in its fight against Russia's invasion. Next up, there has been a proposal filed by a Russian legislator to introduce the term non-fungible tokens to Russian law. As of now, the concept of NFTs do not exist in the Russian legal field, which is why the NFT owners handle these digital assets at their own risk.
The rights of the NFT owners must be respected and protected. This concept of NFTs is not recognized in Russia, and transactions involving NFT tokens are undertaken at their own risk. While cryptocurrency has improved, NFT is not a cryptocurrency, but rather a digital proof of ownership. This is why we suggest regulating NFT intellectual property, as reported by TASS. TASS News Agency reports that the effort aims to distinguish or basically introduce NFT tokens from fungible tokens of unique digital assets. The training will be conducted through a blockchain system. There was a new law enacted in January 2021 that defines digital financial assets. Now, this includes cryptocurrencies and tokens. The finance minister submitted a new law on digital currency in February that is expected to pass this year. According to the proposed bill, the use of cryptocurrencies as a payment instrument will remain banned on Russian territory. But however, digital currency will be only considered as an investment. The bill says Russia would establish a special registry of exchanges and exchange offices capable of carrying out actions connected to organizing the circulation of digital currencies. Moreover, the government proposed creating a threshold for assessing investors' capacity to invest in the cryptocurrency industry and segregating them accordingly. The bill asks that cryptocurrency exchanges and other platforms that deal with digital currencies be regulated in Russia. All cryptocurrency platforms must accept payments and withdrawals from traditional banks.
The exchanges must also meet certain standards for corporate governance, data storage and reporting. And now moving on to our next coverage. Today, the Terraform Labs took to Twitter to inform the users of the customers that no D app have been launched on Terra 2.0 network. The aim behind the Twitter statement was to warn its customer against fraud proposals.
The Twitter post said that recently, a lot of posts are being made and circulated on social media that basically are fraud or fake, and that misleads the user to a link that claims to be a preview of Terra 2.0 and D apps. The recent historic crash of Terra environment tokens has been acting as an advantage for the same. Continuous attempts are made to take advantage of the whole situation, which will lead to more agony for unsuspecting victims. Terraform Labs stated that because these bad actors can now purchase Luna at a discount. Phony proposals have been placed on Terra Station in an attempt to lure customers to the fraudulent DIA. This means taking advantage of the discount that makes it a lot affordable for people to post anything. There has been an increase in the spam proposal on social media. Besides issuing a warning for all its users, Terraform Labs also came up with a solution to protect its users from becoming a victim of these scams. The company announced that certain props will be added to allow a list of to avoid scams, which will assure to protect all users for some time now. However, this is a temporary solution. The company claims to be trying to come up with a more sustainable method to stop these types of props from being uploaded on Terra's government's platform. And now, how do users have an idea about what is a scam or fraud proposal? Simple clicking on the show all button on the governance page will let the user see all the proposals, including the scam ones. Since Terraform Labs already pointed out that the cheap and affordable cost required to launch new proposals or required to launch post on its platform is one of the most major reasons for the increase in scam proposals. It is also considering the possibility of increasing the cost price.
However, this whole process may take as long as at least 7 days for governance, during which time many scams, spam would continue to cause problems and losses. Lastly, winding up with our last coverage for today, European Central Bank President Christine Lagarde took a dig at crypto assets by saying that they aren't worth nothing.
Lagarde, while in conversation with the Dutch TV show College Tour, in an interview said, "I have said all along that crypto assets are highly speculative, very risky assets. My very humble assessment is that it is worth nothing. It is based on nothing, and there is no underlying asset to act as an anchor of safety." Her comments came at a time when the crypto market has been witnessing multiple crashes. Earlier in May, Bitcoin lost 20% of its value in a single week. Lagarde also revealed that she doesn't hold any crypto asset herself because she wants to practice what she preaches. She, however, said that her son has invested in crypto asset against her advice. Lagarde, commenting on digital euro, stated that the day when we have the central bank digital currency, any digital euro, I will guarantee it. So the central bank will be behind it. I think that is vastly different from any of those things. The ECB president further addressed monetary policies, referring that the bank is all ready to hike interest rates in July to fight raging inflation in the eurozone. However, downplaying the chance of a 50 basis point move, she said that a 50 basis point move hike is not something that I can tell you at this point here today.
So with this, we will round off our analysis for today and see you all tomorrow with even more exciting content. In the meantime, if you have any recommendations or opinions, do let us know in the comment section below. For instructions, reviews and tutorial, do visit our blog, which is linked right below. Do not forget to subscribe to the channel to receive daily crypto market updates. Thanks for watching and have a wonderful day ahead.